إن الحمد لله تعالى نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهد الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل على سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أرسله بالحق بشيرا ونذيرا بين يدي الساعة. من يطع الله ورسوله فقد رشد، ومن يعص الله ورسوله فقد ضل غوى. وإنه لا يضر إلا نفسه ولا يضر الله شيئا. إن خير الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم، وإن خير الأمور عوازمها، والشر الأمور محدثاتها، كل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. أما بعد، يقول الله عز وجل في كتاب الكريم بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته، يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا، يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. ثم ما بعد. Indeed, all praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We praise Him. We seek His assistance. And to Him, and only Him, do we turn in repentance. We seek the forgiveness of Allah for the evil of ourselves and for the evil of our actions. And whom shall Allah guide, to them can mislead. And whoever is led astray, there is no guide for him. And we all testify that there is none worthy of worship except for Allah subhanahu wa jalla wa ala. And we all testify that Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the final and beloved messenger of Allah subhanahu wa jalla wa ala. My dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, welcome to Yawm al-Jum'ah, the best day of the week on this fourth day of Rajab, 1,441 years after the Hijrah of beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We make dua to Allah subhanahu wa jalla wa ala, since we're less than 2 months away from the great month of Ramadan. Allahumma ballighna Ramadan. May Allah subhanahu wa jalla wa ala allow us to once again in our lives experience the month of Ramadan. Allahumma ameen. Ikhwal Islam, before we begin, I have a couple of quick announcements for you, inshallah. It's one of the things I've been noticing in a lot of the masajid. A lot of people do not understand the rights and the huquq of the Friday prayer. And so a lot of people, maybe not be here, but maybe on the other floors, you may be doing it yourself and you don't realize. We'd appreciate if you turn all your phones off. No text messaging, no email reading, no internet searching, no video, no audio, no recordings, inshallah. Just listen to the khutbah, inshallah, and try to benefit from inshallah ta'ala. If you have a sickness, if you have an issue with the wall, and you need the wall behind you, please make sure that you use the wall and do not fall asleep, but don't comfortably lean up the wall. The other thing is, this is broken into different floors, so I'd appreciate it, any brothers in the first floor, meaning the main floor, if you can come upstairs, inshallah, to help us complete the rows here. Because behind the imam, the rows should always be complete. When you're making salah, we should not have a broken rose up here and another rose downstairs. So I would appreciate it if everybody comes up here if you can. Inshallah, we'll get you out of time. You know me, I come on time, I leave on time, inshallah. I don't have a lot to say. I say within my time limit, inshallah, and I leave. So I want everybody to please just respect this. No phones, no talking, no playing, no, you don't even say shush to anybody next to you. Just listen to the khutbah. This is not my words. This is the words of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And so just like a great prophet of Allah subhanahu wa jalla wa ala, the prophet of this ummah, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, I wanted to touch today, inshallah ta'ala, on another prophet of Allah subhanahu wa jalla wa ala. This is a great prophet of Allah subhanahu wa jalla wa ala. His name is Yunus alayhi salam. In the English, we refer to him as Jonah. Jonah, may God's peace and blessings be upon him. Also, he's known as many other names. The Noon. The Noon in the English is of the big fish, or Ashab al-Hut, the companion of the big fish, or the whale in this instance. The whale instance that takes place, the incident that takes place, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in ayats of the Quran about this beautiful incident that takes place with the whale. But how does it all take place? Let's go back, inshallah, and review. What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells about us, what we know from the narration of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the Sahaba ikram, the scholars of Islam, when they gathered this information for us, one of the things that we know is that he was sent to a place in Iraq called Mosul. In another name, it's called Nineveh. And he was sent there. There were more than 100,000 people of that nation. And he went there to give them da'wah. He went there to call to one Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, one God, the one worthy of worship. Except for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there's none worthy of worship. Right? The only one worthy of worship is Allah. So his entire message was, La ilaha illallah. There's none worthy of worship except for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he used to remind them of the punishment. He said to the people of Mosul that if you do not follow Allah, if you don't leave what you're doing, all the wrongdoing that you're involved with, and if you don't come and worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the way he should be worshipped, a great punishment of Allah will overtake you. And he reminded them of the other nations that were overtaken. He reminded them of all these nations that were overtaken by the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he reminded them that if you do not turn back, and constant reminder, a long reminder, not like Nuh alayhi salam for 950 years, but a long reminder. And not one person was accepting his message. It's like us giving the khutbah, and we tell all the people something, and we want them to benefit from it, and not one person benefits. How does that person feel? The person doesn't feel very good. So Yunus alayhi salatu wasalam, being the messenger of Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِنَّ يُونُسَ لَمِنَ الْمُرْسَلِينَ, that indeed Jonah was one of our messengers. So when we sent him there, we told him to get that message across. That he got the message across. No one is following. So now he's getting upset. He's angry. He's irritated. And he's thinking to himself, why am I coming to these stubborn people who do not want to accept Islam, who do not want to accept La ilaha illallah? I'm going to leave. And so he decides to leave. Not one person is accepting. He's doing da'wah for a long time. He decides to leave. The problem was that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had not given him permission to leave. So he does leave. And he said he wants to go very far away. Many of us think like that too, right? You know what, this community here in Nur al-Islam, that's the Nur al-Islam in this Brooklyn area, it's not working very well. I'm going to leave this masjid. I'm going to open up my masjid right down the block. We do it all the time. This da'wah is not working. The way they do pray, or the way the fiqh that they're following, it doesn't work. So we do it all the time. We don't go very far away. But Yunus alayhi salam wants to go far away, wants to go seas and oceans far away from the people. Why? Was he upset with the people? Yes. Why? Because they weren't accepting Allah. They weren't accepting that he's the only one worthy of worship. So he wanted to leave them behind, and he wanted to go to another place. So they accept Islam. So they accept La ilaha illallah. That's what he wanted to do. So he leaves the town, and he's about to board up the ship. Now back in town, once he leaves, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala starts to send the clouds, starts to send his punishment towards them, and these dark black clouds start to show up to people, all those 100,000 people that start looking at the clouds coming at them, and they're thinking to themselves, is this what Yunus alayhi salam was reminding us of? That these clouds are going to come and they're going to overtake us. They're coming to come and overtake us, and they're going to destroy us. And they remembered, just a few towns over, the people of Lut alayhi salatu wassalam in the city of Sudan. They knew what happened to them. They knew that these are people that were destroyed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because they did not leave their illegal practices, and they continued in their practice. When they remembered this, they remembered the message of Yunus alayhi salam. Every single one of those 100,000 plus people in that community, they turned to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They sincerely repented. They all started to cry, plead, beg, make dua to Allah in prayer, say, Ya Rab, forgive us, Ya Rab, forgive us. They repented to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because they repented to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took the clouds back, he took the punishment away, and the entire country, the entire nation of Mosul, that area, that entire qabila, became Muslim. Every one of them accepted that there's none worthy of worship except for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know why Allah took that away? Because every single one of them, there was not one disbeliever left within them. Not one. Not one disbeliever. So when they saw that everyone turned to Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took the clouds away. Allah took subhanahu wa ta'ala took the punishment away from them. Yunus alayhi salam does not know that his work has been done. Now he is on the coast, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us this story. إِذْ أَبَقَ إِلَى الْفُلْكِ الْمَشْحُونِ. He goes in to the laden boat, laden ship. He goes there and he wants to go as far away as possible. As far away as possible. He wants to go past seas and oceans. What happens? As the ship starts to go and sail, clouds and wind, and now the storm is coming his way. The storm starts to come. The boat is going. And now it's starting to sink. It's starting to sink. The people who are on board that ship, they are starting to take all of their luggage, all of their baggage, anything extra that they don't need except for themselves, they toss it overboard. And still the boat is sinking. The ship is sinking. Ship is sinking. Yunus alayhi salam and others are aboard. Allah tells us what happens next. فَسَاهَمَ فَكَانَ مِنَ الْمُضْحَضِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that these people, they started to draw lots. They started to take everybody's names, and they put it into a thing, and whosoever name comes out, he is going to be taken off the ship. He's going to be in the middle of the sea, overboard. Happens the first time, they draw the name, and the name comes out, Yunus alayhi salam. They look at him, they're like, subhanAllah, young man, righteous man, religious man, believer of Allah, we can't do this to him. We'd rather get rid of some of the wicked people in our community. Let's try again. They draw the lot again. They draw the lot again. Yunus alayhi salam's name comes out again, a second time. A second time, the name of Yunus alayhi salam comes out. And they said, this has got to be a coincidence, right? We're going to try again. Shake it real good. Shake it real good. A third time, they take it out again. Yunus alayhi salam. Now Yunus alayhi salam realizes, this is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah has asked him. Allah is requesting of him to come out of this boat. Without a thing, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. He comes up to the boat, he jumps. Allah subhanahu wa jalla wa ala says, فَالْتَقَمَهُ الْحُوتُ وَهُوَ مُلِيمٌ. Whale comes out, whoo, swallows him out. Now Yunus alayhi salam is in the belly of the whale, unconscious. In the belly of the whale, unconscious, inside of the ocean. Inside of the ocean. He's unconscious. And now he starts to hear whispers and voices and things are taking place. And he gains consciousness and he's hearing these things. In the darkness of the belly of the whale, what happens? He asks, Ya Rab, what is this? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala informs him that this is the rocks on the bed of the ocean, the pebbles on the bed of the ocean, they're making tasbih to Allah. Allah. The fishes, the creatures of the sea, they're making tasbih to Allah. Allah. He hears all of these things taking place. Inside of the belly of the whale, Allah subhanahu jalla wa ala is telling us the story. Now he's inside the belly of the whale. It's not comfortable. It's dark. You're inside the belly of another creature. Allah subhanahu jalla wa ala tells us what happens next. When he realizes the error that he has made, that he had left Mosul without the permission of Allah subhanahu jalla wa ala, what does he do? Allah subhanahu jalla wa ala tells us, وَذَا النُّونِ إِذْ ذَهَبَ مُغَاضِبًا فَظَنَّ أَنْ لَنْ نَقْدِرَ عَلَيْهِ فَنَادَى فِي الظُّلُمَاتِ. That when he had left in anger, when he had left in anger, and he was still blameworthy, he was still blameworthy. Allah subhanahu wa jalla wa ala reminded him that he has made a mistake. When he realizes his mistake, he dives into the belly of the well, inside the belly of the well, into prostration, into the sujood to Allah subhanahu wa jalla wa ala. And he calls out, فَنَادَ فِي الظُّلُمَاتِ. And Allah subhanahu wa jalla wa ala says, he doesn't call out in the darkness. He uses the plural of darkness. He said, he calls us out in the darknesses. The first darkness is the belly of the whale. In the belly of the whale is the first darkness. And he's in sujood now. And now he's in the middle, he's in the bottom of the ocean, inside of the ocean. You know, if you go inside of the ocean, if you go dive deep diving, you need to have a headlight on, or you need some type of light with you, otherwise you can't see anything. So there's the darkness. The second level of darkness is the darkness of the ocean. The third level of darkness is now it's nighttime. So the world is dark. The ocean is dark. The belly of the whale is dark. And what does he cry out? La ilaha illa ant. Ya Rab, there's none worthy of worship except you, Ya Rab. Subhanak. Ya Rab, you're absolutely perfect. You have no imperfections whatsoever. إني كنت من الظالمين. That I'm the wrongdoer, Ya Rabbi. I'm of the wrongdoers. I'm the one who made a mistake. In the middle of the ocean, you're talking about the deepest part. No one has made sujood in this part of the world before. This is the man of the man, the Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Rasul, the Nabi of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that is in the bottom of the ocean, making sujood to Allah in the most lowest position, putting his head onto the belly of the whale, whatever he's on, and he's calling up all the way to the skies, above the skies and the earth and the heavens and everything else, and he's calling the Rabb above his throne, and he's telling him, you're the only one worthy of worship, Ya Rabb. I'm the one who's done wrong. You're perfect. I'm imperfect. I made a mistake. Now the mistake here is not, he didn't sin. To leave a town is not sinful. What he did was an error in judgment. And so for that error in judgment, because he did not have the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to leave, so the prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are infallible. They don't sin. They make errors in judgment. So this error in judgment called upon, Allah held him accountable. And so when he's held accountable, he's in the belly of the whale, making this dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This dua of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells us that this is the dua of the distress. That one who is in distress, the one who is in grief, that you call out to Allah, La ilaha illa, subhanak, inni kuntu min al-zalimeen. Basically, I'm a wrongdoer. In other words, Ya Allah, forgive me. I made a mistake. I've done something wrong. Forgive me. Have mercy on me. This is the distress dua. In narration of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah subhanahu jalla wa ala has the angels bring up the good deeds every day. So when you are performing good deeds, Allah subhanahu jalla wa ala, on a daily basis, He has the angels take those deeds up. When those deeds are going up to Allah subhanahu jalla wa ala, every single day, the angels, when they take this every day, they're taking the prayer of Yunus alayhi salam. Every day they're taking it up. Every single day, they take it up from Yunus alayhi salam as well. One day, when they took this up, this dua up, Ya Rab, we brought this prayer of Yunus alayhi salam, but it's the voice, that light is coming from the bottom of the ocean. Is that him? Allah subhanahu jalla wa ala tells the angels, yes, this is my prophet, this is my servant. This is Yunus alayhi salam on the bottom of the ocean making dua to me. Allah subhanahu jalla wa ala recognizes this is his servant. This is the prophet of Allah subhanahu jalla wa ala. This is Yunus, this is Jonah. May God's peace and blessings be upon him. This is Yunus alayhi salam. When he makes this dua, he's in the belly. Some of the scholars say that he was in there for 3 days. Many of them say that he was in there for 40 days. For us, it doesn't make a difference. You know why? Because Allah tells us that had he not been a grateful servant, he would have stayed. That he would have stayed in the stomach of the whale, the belly of the whale, until Yawm al-Qiyamah. Which means that Allah will preserve him in whatever way he desires, in whatever way he wishes, in whatever way he commands. Allah subhanahu jalla wa ala will preserve Yunus alayhi salam inside the belly of the whale. But what did Allah do? Once he's made this dua, Allah has forgiven him. He's now asked the belly, he's asked the whale to release him. So when he releases him onto the side of the coastline, وَأَنْبَتْنَا عَلَيْهِ شَجَرَةً مِّن يَقُطِينَ. A little tree starts to grow on top of, right next to Yunus alayhi salam. A little tree grows next to him. For what? Because he's ill, he's sick. Wait, what environment did he come out of? Today, if you look at scientific facts, the belly of the whale is 8 times more acidic than what we can handle. 8 times more acidity. He's ill. He couldn't even get up. So Allah subhanahu jalla wa ala gives him this tree as shade. The leaves, if they touched him, they were soft. They were supposed to. He had scratch marks. He didn't have scratch. He had rashes. He was ill from the discomfort of the whale. So Allah gives him a cure from the tree. So this leaves, as he's rubbing them, this is helping with the cureness. It is taking care of him. He can eat from this tree as well. So he gives him food, provision, whatever necessary. Allah takes care of whomever he wishes, as he wishes, as he desires. And once he becomes well, what does Allah subhanahu jalla wa ala do? He sends him back. وَأَرْسَلْنَاهُ إِلَى مِئَةِ أَلْفٍ أَوْ يَزِيدُونَ. That we have sent back Yunus alayhi salam to Mosul to go and complete the mission. When he goes in there, he's like, La ilaha illallah. Everybody's already worshiping Allah subhanahu wa jalla wa ala. Allah tells us that the entire 100,000 plus people in that town accepted Islam, accepted him as the only one worthy of worship. This is a story in Allah subhanahu wa jalla wa ala tells that when we allow them to be there, فَآمَنُوا فَمَتَّعْنَاهُمْ إِلَىٰ حِينٍ. They believe and we gave them the enjoyment of this life for a short term, for a while. So Allah subhanahu wa jalla wa ala tells us the story of Yunus alayhi salam in different parts of the Quran, showing us how this great Prophet of Allah went and gave da'wah. How this great Prophet of Allah had become irritated because they weren't accepting, so he walked away without the permission of Allah subhanahu wa jalla wa ala. Allah tested him. Allah tested him with the belly of the whale incident. Allah gave him the chance. He fulfilled his chance by asking Allah subhanahu wa jalla wa ala for forgiveness in the deepest part of the ocean. Asking Allah subhanahu wa jalla wa ala to forgive him. Allah brings him back, cures him, sends him, and lets him see that the entire town that he gave the message to, that they've done very well, alhamdulillah. This is a great story. This is how we have to get closer to the Quran. We are bringing to you closer to the Quran through the stories of the prophets, through the true stories of the messengers, through other stories, inshallah, of the companions, inshallah, as well. Why? Because we need to get closer to the Quran. This is the true book, the true miracle that Allah subhanahu wa jalla wa ala blessed the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is Al-Quran. And this is something that we've gotten very far away from. So by mentioning these stories, we understand that Allah subhanahu wa jalla wa ala is teaching us lessons. And inshallah, in the second khutbah, we'll talk about some of the lessons that we should derive from this story. May Allah subhanahu wa jalla wa ala allow us to understand and implement the Quran in our lives. May Allah subhanahu wa jalla wa ala, when He lifts us, when He takes our souls out, that He takes them on Islam. That we may have La ilaha illallah mentioned in our tongues and in our hearts, that Allah subhanahu wa jalla wa ala pulls out our souls at that one point in time. May Allah subhanahu wa jalla wa ala make it easy for us and our brothers and sisters that are suffering all over the world. May Allah subhanahu wa jalla wa ala make it easy for our community. May Allah subhanahu wa jalla wa ala bless our community, make it easy for us. وَقُولُوا قَوْلِ هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرُوا اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ وَلِسَائِرِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَالْمُسْلِمَاتِ فَاسْتَغْفِرُوهُ إِنَّهُ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين. الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. My dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, the benefits of this story. Number one, we're living in a non-Muslim country. Not only is it an objective for ourselves to stay upon Islam, but it's our objective to make sure that our children, our family is upon Islam as well. And this is the number one objective. First, for yourself. Number two is your family. And number three, whenever you're going out into the community, that you're sharing this message of Islam. Wallahi akhwal Islam. People share outside. They share their disbelief with us. They share their kufr with us. They tell us about the kufr that they're going to perform on a regular basis. And it's our time now and forever that we go to them and we tell them about Iman. And we tell them about the Nur al-Iman, the light of Iman, and what Iman does to a person. So this number one is that the call of Yunus alayhi salam to those people of Mosul and the people of Nineveh, the people 100,000 plus, the entire nation accepted Islam. It's our job to make sure that this nation is also called to Islam. Every single person should hear the message. And we don't have to go door to door. We just have to do it on a regular basis. Be ourselves, be Muslim. Be good believers. Be good character. Be a person who's taking care of yourself and your family, and they'll see. You'll see the benefits in society. Call them to Islam. You know why Yunus alayhi salam, the deeds when they went up to heaven, when they went up to Allah subhanahu wa jalla wa ala, that he was forgiven? Allah tells us that he was always making tasbih, that he was always calling to Allah. That he was always calling to Allah subhanahu wa jalla wa ala. He always turned to Allah subhanahu wa jalla wa ala. So remember this. In your times of good times, remember Allah. You know why? Because if those good times turn bad, Allah subhanahu wa jalla wa ala will remember you. Remember me. So remember him in all times. Constantly pray to Allah. Tasbih is not very difficult. It is the most simplest of things. The greatest scholars of Islam, their tongues been wet with the tasbih of Allah. Subhanallah, alhamdulillah, Allahu Akbar, subhanallah wa bihamdih, subhanallah al-azim. The kalima, subhanallah, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, wahdahu la sharika lah, lahul mulk wa lahul hamd, wa huwa ala kulli shayin qadeer. All of these kalimat, all of these tasbih, make your tongue wet with it constantly. Constantly wet with tasbih. Remembrance in Allah subhanahu wa jalla wa ala. Make as much dhikr as you can of Allah subhanahu wa jalla wa ala. Because this is something that brings you closer to Allah. After the salah, make tasbih. Make as much dhikr as you can. Say the ayat al-kursi. When you say Allahu la ilaha illah, Allahu la ilaha illahu, all the way up to the end, wa huwa al-aliyyul azim. You say this entire ayah. The only thing separating you from Jannah is death. Allahu Akbar. Constantly remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wherever you are. Pray to Allah all the time. Remember Allah at all times. And this is the story of Yunus alayhi salam. Inshallah, when you are close to Allah, constantly making dhikr to Allah, constantly involved in prayer with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you'll see that your family is going to be in better places. Does that mean the tests go away? No. The tests come, but we constantly persevere. You know why? Because we're patient. We have to be patient. This is, even if it's 70 or 80 years, it's a short time, but it's long in the same time. It feels long when you're going through painful moments. But when it's happy times, enjoyment, the time runs away. So those, we want to minimize those times of grief by saying the dua of grief. La ilaha illa anta. Subhan ya Rabb. You're the only one worthy of worship. You're absolutely perfect. Inni kuntu min al-zalimin. I'm 100% the wrongdoer. Allah, have mercy upon us. Forgive us. Make it easy for us. This is the message of Yunus alayhi salam's story. Allah mentioned this story because no one else has made sujood that came before that in the ocean like that. But today, alhamdulillah, we have submarines and we have Muslims in the submarines and in the bottom of the ocean, and they're praying in the bottom of the ocean. But Yunus alayhi salam, this is his sunnah, to pray inside of the ocean, inside of the belly of the whale. I don't know of any other human being that has ever done this. So this is a great story. This is a great story to understand and portray today, because they say that this is from the story of Bible and the Torah. Allahu a'lam what's in the Bible and Torah. I haven't read it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us these stories in the Quran. They believe in Jonah. May God's peace and blessings be upon him. Remind the people here. Remind the Jews and Christians you meet. We believe in the story of Yunus alayhi salam, Jonah, the Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Bring them to Islam. Allow them to understand Islam. But the only way they will correctly understand Islam is if you portray it correctly. So learn about your deen. Get close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Constant remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless our communities. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala unite our hearts. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have shifa for all of the people that are suffering all over the world from the coronavirus. May Allah make it easy for the ummah. May Allah make it easy for all our brothers and sisters that are suffering in India, in Gujarat, and different parts of the world where they're being killed just because they say La ilaha illallah. Ikhwan Islam, just think about this for a second. La ilaha illallah. This is something on the tongue and in the heart, and they're killing us, and we haven't done anything back. And then, and you know what we do? We run away, we just make dua, but that's at least make dua. Hate this in your hearts, but ask Allah to finally grant us some victory. Give us a righteous leader that will follow. Give us a people that are Muslim, that are righteous, and they're going to lead us into the correct path. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for all our Muslim brothers and sisters all over the world. Allahumma aizz al-Islam wa muslimin. Allahumma ansur al-Islam wa muslimin. Allahumma ashfi mardana wa mardal muslimin. Allahumma aghfir warham al-mawtana wa mawtal muslimin. Allahumma aghfir al-mu'minina wal mu'minat wal muslimina wal muslimat. Al-ahya' minhum wal amwat. Allahumma innaka 'afuwun tuhibbul 'afwa fa'fu 'anna. Allahumma aghfirna bi halalik al-haram wa fadlik min fadlik 'amman siwak. Allahumma inna na'udhubika min shururi al-hasad wal-'ajzi wal-kasal wal-bukhl wal-jubn wal-dhal الدين وغلبة الرجال. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه، وارنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. اللهم إذا الإسلام، اللهم ثبتنا على الإسلام، اللهم نبر قلوبنا بنور الإيمان، اللهم آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكوننا من الخاسرين. اللهم اغفر لنا ولإخواننا الذين سبقونا بالإيمان ولا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين آمنوا ربنا إنك رؤوف رحيم. اللهم لا تجعلنا من القوم الظالمين. اللهم لا تجعلنا فتنة للقوم الظالمين. اللهم هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين واجعلنا المتقين إماما. اللهم تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين. أقم الصلاة.